You've been properly warned. I don't want to hear you bitch.
Oh, make me over. I'm all I want to be. A walking study. Look at my face. My name is might have been. My name is never was. My name forgotten.
Hi, thanks for tuning in. I'm Elizabeth, and I'm here to share with you my journey of my Fleur De Lis abdominoplasty. I hoped to make an informative video that would help people decide on the procedure if they were unsure, and also help kind of shepherd them through their recovery. It's a big surgery, it's a big deal, and I figure as much guidance as people can get, you know, that's a good thing. So I hope you find this informative, and so I'm here to share my journey of getting this surgery and what led me to this point. This video has been a long time in the making. Not only did the recovery take a long time, so it was a lot of footage that was compiled, it took a long time to get to the point where I was ready to have surgery. I used to be pretty significantly overweight, and I made a decision about 7 years ago, almost 8 years ago now, to really fix my relationship with my body and fix my relationship with food. And I had tried to lose weight many times before and had yo-yoed quite a bit, which probably was contributory to the state that my skin was in. But at the time that I took charge of my life, I was in like a size 22 pants, had a big old booty and then some, and I just was really, really, really unhappy. My mobility was limited. I didn't enjoy being in my body. I didn't like looking at it. I didn't like the way it felt. But I didn't know if I could do any better because I had been so up and down through all the years, and I did all the diet pills and all the, you know, fad diets, and nothing really stuck. So I had to figure out why was I heavy? Why was I not listening to my body? Why was I overfeeding my body? Why was I not moving my body enough? And for a long time, it was uncomfortable to move this body that I didn't like being in, but the only way to get to where I wanted was to get really uncomfortable, and so that's what I did. I got down to a weight where I was ready to start reconstruction. My skin damage is pretty extensive, and I still have more procedures to go to fix the rest of my body. But this was the second one I've undergone. I first had my breast done, although I was never having it in my chest area. I kind of wanted just a something to a treat yourself, if you will. And I did. I went and met Dr. Repta, and I joke that we bolted on some boobs and began our journey, and my journey to actualize myself in a way that I was happy about and am happy about. This tummy tuck was something I researched for many years. I found Dr. Repta after years and years of research, and it was between him and Dr. Hunstad. They've both worked together, and they both have pioneered techniques together. Dr. Repta happened to be closer to me, distance-wise, so I met him, and instantly I trusted him. He's very nice, very kind, and incredibly skilled. The bevy of patients that he's had that have undergone these reconstructions, the results are unimaginable, results that I didn't even think were attainable via plastics. So this whole procedure has exceeded any of my wildest dreams and expectations. And it's truly been life-changing. You'll see many times through this video, I get emotional, and it's starting a little bit now because it really has made such a huge impact on my life in every area. I was so self-conscious about what I was carting around. I had 6 pounds of skin removed. That was what the Fleur De Lis, the giant chunk of skin, it weighed 6 pounds. I am so happy to be rid of it. It was a lot to schlep around, and it really, really took its toll on me. And so to be free of it is a freedom that I cannot quite express. So if this applies to you, and this is where you're at, and you're considering the surgery, I can't make up your mind for you, but I can tell you that it has truly been the best decision I've ever made. And all of the investments I've made in myself have been some of the best investments I've made in my life, and I've never once regretted any of them. Enjoy the video. I hope you find what you were seeking, and thank you for spending some time with me. You want a part of me? Walmart had no acceptable nightgowns, so I bought from the Vatos Locos collection.
Oh, really?
I'm white on the outside, but I'm brown on the inside. This is how we do it.
It is safe to look, all you squeamish folks. Open your eyes. Back to the video.
Hola. It is 6:36 right now. I swear to fuck, Brennan, if you distract me again, this is my second time making the same update. He think he funny. So I'm like 7.5 hours out of surgery. And everything is going like it's to be expected. But what you need to do is expect a lot. It's gnarly, not unbearable, not you're going to be sitting there crying and whimpering. But you definitely have to be mindful of how you move your body. With the Fleur De Lis, it really worked my guts over in a good way, but there was a lot of work done. So, it's not easy to maneuver around. You really shouldn't be maneuvering too much. There's a sweet spot, you know, where you move enough to avoid, like, you know, blood clots, but not so much to literally bust a gut. Don't be a hero. Take your pain meds because you want to try and get on top of the pain. You don't want to let it spike, because if it spikes, you're going to feel like shit. Find a comfy spot. Listen to the position your doctor said and try and relax. You're getting in this shot. I'm going to post this on YouTube. I don't know how, not that many people, because my videos don't get very many views, but that's enough. Enough people saw that. I'm not editing it. Haha! I told you. I was very clear. I said, Brendan, I am making a video diary. I am trying to help people with their Fleur De Lis recovery, because most of the videos aren't that informative. And I said, this is the second time I'm making it. I am not redoing the scene. Sucks to be you. Fuck it! No, it's happening. It's happening. I'll try and put a sticker over you or something, but I don't know how good that's going to do. So I'll update again. Things are going well. It's about as expected. It's gnarly, but worth it. Okay. Next pro tip. Sorry for the hotel lighting and glare. Oh, I still have my hospital bracelets on. When you get up to use the restroom, which you're supposed to do like every hour, that's like enough steps. And you empty your drainage bag and all that. The trip back from the bathroom can be a little dicey. Like, you are moving, picture the slowest senior citizen ever. Now, I don't know if that's the case for like a normal tummy tuck, but this extended Fleur De Lis, you're like hunched over and moving like a grandma. By the time I get back in bed, and this has happened kind of like every bathroom break, I'm a little shaky. And depending on where the Valium is in your system, maybe a lot shaky. So, just cause like, you know, your muscles are spasming and freaking out cause they're like, what the fuck just happened to me? So I would recommend if you can space your, Valium or whatever other, narcotic, is that a narcotic Valium? Whatever other thing you were given. Try and time it with your bathroom breaks to ease that transition so it's not so traumatic going from, you know, recliner or bed to toilet and back. I can't sleep. I'm not super uncomfortable. I'm a little uncomfortable, but I think the pain meds... Yeah, I'm making an update. I think the pain meds... make me a little busy brained, so I'm having a hard time settling down. And then I go to watch TV and it's fucking boring. TV sucks, but I don't feel like watching Netflix either. But reading a book's kind of inconvenient when your night nurse is trying to sleep. He's up now getting me more medication. Stool softeners, which by the way, just preemptively take enough stool softener and fiber to turn your poo to mush, because you won't be pooing for a while, but when you do, you're going to want to be comfortable and not feel like you're, this is the second bust a gut reference, but you don't want to feel like your insides are ripping out. Any C-section mom knows that, but, yeah. Okay, so we're almost 24 hours out of surgery. Still is a dragon to ride, but not an unmanageable one. My body is starting to feel, I'm acclimating more to this new shape. It was very strange. I was almost having, like, I don't want to say phantom pain because pain is not the word, but you're so used to the loose skin that you've been carting around, at least I was, because it's been many, many, many years. That, you know, you feel pain in your abdominal muscles and you go to feel something that's not there. It's very interesting. And, I actually ended up looking at the surgery pictures, so that I could like confirm to myself that nothing was growing back, as ridiculous as that sounds. But when you're so used to something being there, having it gone is almost too good to be true. And it's almost beyond belief. So, psychologically, there's some adjustments. Oh, it's making me emotional, but in a good way. This was truly life-changing. And even though it's a burly recovery, it's fucking worth it. Already there's so many positive differences, even though, you know, I'm still walking like a granny and shuffling and pretty much bedridden. Already life-changing differences. So I'm so happy I did this. It's every single improvement I have made to my physical body, I've never regretted. It's all worth it, and the positive changes just compound. So I'll update more as things go on, and that's where we're at. Morning of day two, day one of full day two, whatever fucking day you want to call it. Yeah. Feel like shit right now. This is the longest stretch I've slept. It was like 11 to what the fuck time is it? 2:33. Oh my god. Like, I got up and I got, when I went back to the bathroom, my teeth were chattering. Oh man, that was a rough one. Phew. Today is Sunday. Sabbath day. Day of our Lord. I am feeling a little better. My strength is building every day, but yeah, we're still a human center beating it. I included, or will include, depending on how I edit this together, I've been doing little walks around the hotel room, and then walks on this here balcony. But when before I get into bed, after I get up and use the facilities, here, we'll angle down. So I'll stand and I'll kind of, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4 to 50, and same with that one. And then I do ankle circles as well, and then I'll do the ankle circles while I'm in bed too, because I'm so really, really, really doing everything I can to try and prevent them. And sometimes they just happen and it's terrible, but do your part as a patient to prevent them. So yeah, that's what I'm doing. Just trying to get some fresh air here. I just slept the longest I think I've slept through this process. I think I was like 5 or 6 hours. So yeah, it's shockingly a beautiful morning here in fucking Arizona. The only redeeming quality about this state is my plastic surgeon. But yeah, not a terrible Sunday to wake up to.
Roll another blunt. Yeah.
Okay. Here comes my ride. This is about to happen.
People of Walmart, hear me. Now I am your lizard queen. I can do anything. My first decree: scooters for all. Walmartians, my next decree as your royal leader: all live, laugh, love signs are being gathered and thrown into a dumpster fire. Sorry. Also, any loose-fitting capri pant, platform wedge, sandal below 2 inches, gone. Riding on a scooter with a drainage tube, looking at great value stuff. Everything's a great value here. Does anybody notice that? I mean, if you didn't notice, they tell you on the packaging. See, right there. Great value, saltines. It is a great value. They're 98 cents. And the other ones are $2.74, so they're not lying. We're gonna build a wall around the horchata aisle. It's gonna be huge, and the night crew's gonna pay for it. Where are the fucking books? I came here for books. This is beef. Picked up some shrimp though. Hey, Walmartians. I came here for books, you know. The things with the paper. It's a little tougher than the stuff you wipe your ass with, and there's all these little black squiggles all over it. Books.
Those are the first person in Walmart history.
No, I don't mean a copy of Guns and Ammo. I mean a fucking novel. Book. I won't even ask for a classic. I'll take some Dean Koontz pile of shit. I don't care at this point.
What a fucking shock. Magazines and picture books. No. Oh, thank God. Look, there's 3 novels down there. Great. You have got to be kidding me. Stormy Daniels books. Nicholas motherfucking Sparks. Books about Trump. That fucking whore. I wanted a book. I just wanted a book.
Okay, so I have been a very naughty patient. Very naughty. I thought I was doing well by doing little trips and, you know, slowly pushing myself. Apparently, that was bad. I'm fine. I'm totally fine. But I went to my follow-up appointment, the day before yesterday. And, I was so proud about all I've been doing, and my doctor, although very kind, I could tell he was displeased, and he said, in very professional terms, what would basically boil down to get your ass back in bed. He said, up into the bathroom is enough, and then back to bed, because every time you move, even though I adjust it back properly, your binder's moving, and that's, you know, not good. And all those things. So I'm trying so hard to sit in bed. He said, stay another week in Phoenix and come back and see me on the 6th. I believe that's Tuesday. So I am in bed. That's good. But I'm not in Phoenix. So I went home. I didn't drive myself or anything. But I'm laying in my own bed. In my fluffy cloud room, everything's white. It's beautiful. I love my room. So that's where I'm at. I'm really trying to just vegetate, and it sucks because there's a lot of shit I want to do. But he said, invest in your recovery, and he's fucking right. You invest enough money in the surgery, in time and pain, invest in the recovery and do it right. So I am fucking grounded. Meh. But yeah, that's that. I'm totally off the perky C's, the Percocets, and I'm on like Motrin and Advil. Yeah, doing well. I will update. I forgot the best part. At the appointment, we remove the binder. They take off, they kind of wrap you with what equates to, it looks like quilt batting. After your surgery, and then your binder goes on. Okay, so you've got your sutures, and then there's Steri-Strips tape, but not medical tape, Steri-Strips, it's different. You'll see if you've never had it. And then around that was the batting, and then the binder. So at the follow-up appointment, we removed the binder, removed the batting. I got to see myself, and it was another tear-jerking moment. I'm going to hold it together right now, but I was crying, just crying and crying and crying, because sure, I'm swollen, sure, there's bruising, sure, there's, you know, miles and miles of sutures, but I look like a person, and fuck, I'm losing it, forget it. For the first time, I can say, like, my body is beautiful, and I can stand by that, and it's not like something that you're just telling yourself, you know, to like positively brainwash yourself. It actually is, and I think, like, you know, this is what I would have looked like had I not. This is what I would have looked like had I plugged into mindfulness earlier and been in a place where I could have taken better care of myself.
Driving back for my next follow-up appointment, it's like I never left, right?
Look at that over there.
No, just came more fucking desert. Look how many bugs died on the windshield. There. There. There's no will to live out here.
I have been recovering for so long, it's not even funny. It starts to kind of like take its toll on your mental health. I get out when I can, but it's hard to be, like, not on your game for weeks and weeks and weeks. I'm trying to keep my perspective because, like, I'm here by my own choosing. This is self-inflicted. There are other mothers who are infirm through no choosing of their own, and they want to take care of their babies in their house probably even more than I do. So I'm keeping that in mind so as not to, like, be so first world problem in my whine about this massive recovery. I knew what I was signing up for. But when it's like an abstract number, like, you know, however huge chunks of weeks, you know, I don't think it really hits you until you're actually in the thick of it. I'm recovering well, but we're like, you know, 4 weeks out of surgery. I still have a drain, which is normal. And I knew I'm a very slow healer. Historically, every operation I've ever had has taken like way longer to heal. I heal beautifully, but very slowly. So that's where we are right now. I'm hoping within the next week, this drain is going to come out. All my sutures, most of them have dissolved. There's a few areas where they have not yet, but, the closures are looking great. I'm feeling good, but still have to take it easy. Still can't lift, still can't work out hard. I stroll, and slowly. So not even up to like normal walking yet. It's the long haul and we're in it.
Thank you all so much for watching, and I wish you the best of luck in your journey. You can do it. You got this. I believe in you. Namaste.
Made a wrong turn once or twice. Dug my way out, blood and fire. Bad decisions, that's alright. Welcome to my silly life. Mistreated, this place misunderstood. Misknowing it's all good, it did. Yourself, you were wrong. Change the voices.